Bless your name, Jesus. Bless your name. I'm just going to touch and agree with you in faith. Hallelujah. Praise God. The anointing is here. And all you got to do is just praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Believe it.
Yeah.
to him, that can recognize it's him, and then that can give over to his spirit. Is that right? So that's why the old man in us, amen, the old flesh, the old carnality, amen, pray that God to die. As long as the flesh, amen, praise God, amen, takes control in your life, you will never recognize he's in the house. You'll miss your blessing every time. Say amen. You wonder, is that really him? Listen, when you feel his presence, you get up and praise God. Is that right? You don't have to wait, amen, to the anointing of God is almost gone, then finally get. No, as soon as you recognize that he is here, hallelujah, we are to give him glory. Even we praise him before we know he's here. But thank God, he's been here today. Amen. Came the Spirit of the Lord in the midst of the congregation. That's just like we aren't we a congregation of people today? Praise God. And he said, now he came and he wanted to say something. Hearken ye all Judah. Amen. Now Judah and Israel were twin sisters. Amen. Say amen. Amen. They were sister churches. Amen. They were, in other words, people of God. Amen. Say amen. Amen. And they were God's chosen people. Amen. Amen. Not Gentiles. Gentiles had not came into focus at this time as to become one of God. Amen. It was Judah and Israel. All the others were those that fought against God's people. Amen. Just like today, the devil still want to fight against God's people. Amen. Is that right? The devil want to see, amen, the work of God go down. Amen. But as long as we stay on our knees, the work of God will go up. Amen. Amen. He's not a downloader. He's an uploader. Say amen. Praise the Lord. He's not like a computer. Amen. Brother Farmer, you got to download it and find it. No, uncle, you don't have to download God. He's just what he said he is. Say amen. He's not sick. He doesn't have a glitch. Say amen. Praise God. You call on him. If your life is right and you can get into it, God, all you got to say, Jesus. He said, listen, I'm right here. Hallelujah. Praise God. Something about the name. There's power in his name. Say amen. Hallelujah. Bless your name, Jesus. And he said, hearken ye, all Judah, and the inhabitants of Jerusalem, and thy King Jehoshaphat. Also, he's not only speaking to the congregation, he's speaking to the king. Amen. Say amen. Amen. Thus saith the Lord unto you. Praise God. Be not afraid, not dismayed. Dismays me. Don't you be disturbed. Amen. I don't care what the devil said. Don't you be disturbed. Amen. Say amen. Keep your focus on the Lord. Amen. Say amen. By reason of this great multitude. Amen. The multitude were those that were against them. Amen. Say amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. But listen, I don't care. Amen. Pray. We might be few in number, but you know what? In God, we're Lord. Because we have the majority. Amen. We have Jesus Christ. Amen. It can be thousands and thousands of people against the sinners and backsliding hypocrites. Amen. Praise God. Amen. But listen, praise God. As long as God's in the midst, we got the majority. Amen. That's right. Amen. We have the majority. Father, bell, listen, is not yours. Touch the neighbor and say, the things I face and the things I shall face are not mine. Tell somebody, tell somebody. Say amen. The Bible says here, for the bow, that's your trial. That's your test. Whether it's sickness, whether it's lying, accusation, praise God, fighting against the warfare, turmoils, on the job, in the family, in the home, in the school, even can be some weak people in the church. But listen, the battle is not ours. Oh, you better talk to me today. If God said it's not my battle, then it's not my battle. I am in agreement with God. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Lord Jesus. The things I have to go through, the things that I have to, it's not mine. It's only a test. God wants to prove himself. Amen. To show himself strong in love. Show himself mighty. He's a mighty battle axe. Hey, what's up? Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Praise God. It says, praise God. Amen. Praise God. Amen. Be not afraid. Not dismayed. Don't be afraid. Amen. Don't be dismayed. Don't be discouraged. Amen. by reason of this great multitude. I don't care if it's one or if it's 10,000 that's against us, that we have Jesus in on our side. Amen. We are still the majority.
Amen.
For the battle is not yours, but God.
Amen.
Say amen.
Amen.
And listen, then he speaks that and let Judah and Jehoshaphat and those in Jerusalem know. Amen. The battle is. Say amen. It's God. And now he gives them instruction. Tomorrow, and see, when God speaks, you better follow.
Amen.
When God speaks, you better do what he said.
Amen.
Without reservation. Say amen. Amen. You can't even talk about Friday night. I may mention to you, Elder Mountain brought the word, but I add amen that God can use you to be slowful.
Amen.
Ain't you know slow. Slowful means lazy. Say amen, honey. You got to be ready. You got to get up in the morning.
Amen.
I don't care what your agenda is. You got to get up in readiness to hear the voice of God.
Amen.
God changed your plan.
Amen.
God turned things around.
Amen.
Say amen. God said, well, you got this on your agenda. But God said, no, I want you to do that.
Amen.
Say amen. And so what you going to do? You're going to obey God.
Amen.
Cancel your plans and please God.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. He says, amen. Tomorrow go ye down against them. I'm going to go against the enemy on tomorrow. Behold, they come up by the cliff of this, and ye shall find them at the end of the brook before the wilderness of Jerusalem. God knows where you're going.
Amen.
You remember Judas? He was right there in the midst of Jerusalem.
Amen.
Is that right?
Amen.
Amen. He was one chosen by God.
Amen.
Amen. But he was the one, amen, that betrayed Jesus. Is that right? Amen. Didn't it betray
him?
Praise God. He was the one. Say amen. Praise God. Amen. But, praise God. Amen. He could never repent. He never got it right. He went away. They called the grief. See, the devil never showed you what your final estate is.
Amen.
He just tells you to do this, do that. He never tell you the end of his other. And what he did, he ran off. The burden and grief was on him more than he could bear. And amen, he committed suicide. Killed himself. Say amen. And no one that kills himself, take their own life and go to heaven.
Amen.
Say amen. For the Bible says there's no repentance in the grave.
Amen.
Say amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. So therefore, praise God. Amen. The word of God said, tomorrow, go ye down against them. Behold, they come up by the cliff of Ziz. He gives them instruction where the enemy is.
Amen.
And ye shall find them at the end of the brook, before the wilderness of Jeruah. Ye shall not need to fight in this battle. See, sometimes, amen, things come up and things can hurt you. You can be about to cry, burdened, depressed. But then, amen, you prayed about it, then God will have you shut your mind.
Amen.
If God's going to fight your battle, you got to stop your ear.
Amen.
Is that right? Amen. Praise God. You got to stand back and you pray and you give it to God, then shut up.
Amen.
Now, other words, go forth and give God glory.
Amen.
Believing God is already done before it happens.
Say,
you shall not need to fight in this battle. Set yourself. Stand ye still. And see the salvation of the Lord with you. Is that right?
Oh,
don't just sit with you.
Amen.
Say amen. Listen, do you know right now Jesus is right by your side?
Amen.
He's right there. I don't care what it is. I don't care what you had faced yesterday, what you're going to face today. Amen. But you got to know he's right there with you. And not only that, he's right there in it with you. Is that right? He's ready to work for you. He's ready to fight for you. He's ready to deliver you. Now be dismayed. Amen. And you know the reason why Jehoshaphat feared? It was simply because in chapter 19 of 2 Chronicles, amen, praise God, thank you, Jesus, Jehu spoke a word to him. And see, you got to watch what people say.
Amen.
People can drop an evil spirit on you.
Amen.
And sometimes, I'm not talking about in the world, I'm talking about people in the church.
Amen.
They can say something and mess up your day.
Amen.
And they don't even know it, but they're just releasing that feeling.
Amen.
You can always speak your feeling.
Amen.
Amen. Your feeling don't mean God is talking to you.
Amen.
Say amen. Praise God. I don't know about God talking to feelings. I know God speaks to the heart.
Amen.
Say amen. It says, praise God, 19 and 1 and 2. And Jehoshaphat the king of Judah returned to his house in peace to Jerusalem. He went in peace. When you've done the will of God, you feel peace.
Amen.
You don't have to ask nobody, well, how do you think I did?
Amen.
If the peace of God is upon you, that's all right.
Amen.
Say amen. Because you better watch how you ask for people. People, how they think. All was good, but
amen.
Say amen. Amen. Praise God. Now that destroys you. That but destroys your peace.
Amen.
Say amen. Praise God. See, and Jehoshaphat, the king of Judah, returned to his house in peace. It was well with his soul.
Amen.
To Jerusalem. And Jehu, the son of Hanani, the seer, went out to meet him and said to King Jehoshaphat, shouldest thou help the ungodly? Why didn't you go help the ungodly? Should you have helped them? You don't need to help them.
Amen.
Say amen. But did not the Bible say, for God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten Son?
Yes.
That whosoever believes in him should not perish but have everlasting life. Did not Jesus die for the whole universe?
Yes.
And he died for the haters?
Yes.
He died for the heathen?
Yes.
At one time, we were all under him.
Amen.
Say amen. Oh, we just got saved some years ago, but listen, one time we were under him.
Amen.
We were walking in our own way, not even caring.
Amen.
Is that right?
Amen.
Doing what we thought we'd like to do.
Amen.
Say amen. Praise God. It says, shouldest thou help the ungodly and love them that hate the Lord? Should you love them? Say amen. But nowhere in God's word did God ever tell us to hate or despise.
Amen.
He said, love the enemy.
Amen.
Is that in our Bible?
Amen.
Do good for those that
despise.
Do good to them. Treat them nice.
Amen.
Say amen. Praise God. And love them that hate the Lord. Therefore is wrath upon thee from before the Lord. And then he tries to polish it up in verse 3. Nevertheless, there are good things found in thee. Other words, you did that and shouldn't have done that. You're not all bad. When a child is not all bad, he just needs to learn some discipline. Praise God. Yes, it works, but he just don't know how to sit down. Say amen. So it said, nevertheless, there are good things found in thee, in that thou hast taken away the grove out of the land, the groves where they went and worshiped out of God, and hast prepared thine heart to seek God. Now that's the other words, what he's saying, that's all good. But now, back in